Hello, Virgo. Welcome to another love reading. This love reading will be all about the person you're connecting with or thinking about at this time. What do you need to know about their thoughts, feelings, intentions towards you? And what do they wish they could tell you? Keep in mind that this reading is for the Virgo collective, so it will not resonate for every single Virgo watching. And let's jump into the reading for Virgo, spirit, angels, guides. What do we need to know about this person that Virgo is thinking about or connecting with? What does this person think about Virgo? What are their feelings towards Virgo? What is their overall energy when it comes to Virgo? Spirit, what is this person's overall energy? It's their main energy when it comes to Virgo or this connection with Virgo. The Magician, and I want to take this one too. Wow, and the Ace of Cups. Okay, this person's manifesting you. They're manifesting love. They are wanting to make something happen here, get this party started. They're manifesting love with you, Virgo. Now, bottom of the deck is the Seven of Pentacles, which tells me they've been waiting for this for some time. They might be having doubts or anxieties about whether this could ever happen. Does my future include Virgo? I don't know, I'm not sure, etc. Let's get some more insight. Tell me more about the Magician and the Ace of Cups. Now, the Magician is a doer. They take action. So whoever this is that's having this main energy towards you, the main energy is action. So this is someone that would take charge of the situation and make something happen. Oh my gosh, and as I say that, there's the Four of Cups. Okay, so this person's not happy. Wow, the Two of Cups. No, this person, whoever they are, there's something special about you, Virgo. You're not like the others. Feel like they've dated, maybe they've been with other people, maybe they've, you know, met other people. It's just not in, they're not interested. It's not enough for them. That's not what they're looking for. It's like nothing compares to you, Virgo, or like it's just not you. They might be perfectly fine people, but it's just not you, because you are a Two of Cups to this person. Interesting. Tell me about the Magician or the Ace of Cups. What do we need to know? What do we need to know about this energy? Four of Pentacles. Yeah, they're holding on to you, whoever this is. It's you and no one else. Very interesting. Knight of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. This is someone who only sees you as their option. You are the only one that they see themselves with, the only ones that they can, that they would do all this work for, that they would manifest. I mean, it's like whatever's going on here, it's you and no one else, like I said earlier. No one else will do, you know? Like that song. What else do we need to know about this person's overall energy? Okay. Sudden realization, clarity, truth, epiphany. A sudden realization has brought new clarity. What is this person's overall energy towards Virgo? What is this person's overall energies? Burning passion. Passion, intimacy, chemistry. The chemistry is off the chart. Yeah, there's something about you that they're realizing is different. There's something about this connection. There's passion. There's a genuine chemistry, attraction. But I feel like it goes deeper. I just think that this person can't stop thinking about you. Some of you, I feel, Virgo, you're like the one that got away. Obviously, that's not all of you, but some of you, you are. And this person, they're just not able to get over you, to be honest. I don't feel like you are with this person right now. Let's see what else we get. What is this person's overall energy when it comes to Virgo? What is this person's overall energy when it comes to Virgo? What do we need to know? of this person's overall energy when it comes to Virgo. Curse, bad luck, punishment, karma. Interesting. Four of Cups. I did think this person's not happy. But I think that they were dealing with some sort of karmic situation. I think they had bad luck. I think they've been punished. Or they feel punished. Either you punish them or life punished them. Yeah, I feel like this person, this sudden realization is because this person is realizing something about whatever situation is going on for them right now that's not fun. What else do we need to know about this person's energies towards Virgo? Sleeping curse, inaction, silence, dormancy. So there has been no action from this person. Maybe that's why, the Knight of Pentacles is the slowest knight, but the Magician is a doer. Although I don't see any action down here. I think this person is just trying to manifest you. Bottom of the deck, adventure, taking risks, initiative, and excitement. Similar to the Ace of Wands here. So I think this person is waking up with sudden realization, with sleeping curse. I think this person is waking up. Maybe they've been laying dormant for some time, silent for some time. What do they wish they could tell Virgo at this time, this person, Spirit? What do they wish they could tell Virgo at this time? What message do they have for Virgo? What message do they have for Virgo? Seven of Pentacles. Interesting. Seven of Pentacles shows up again. So it's important. I feel like this person has been laying in wait. Or lying in wait. What's the terminology there? They are also having a bit of doubt here. Yeah, the Emperor, Aries energy, Two of Wands at the bottom of the deck. So what I'm thinking here is that this is somebody who normally they would just take action and like get it done, get it out of the way. The Emperor is used to getting their way. The Emperor is someone that is very hands-on, kind of like step aside, I'll take over from here. That's the energy of the Emperor. The Emperor, though, they don't like making mistakes. The Emperor has lived long enough and been through several battles in his life that he already knows that strategy is very important, decisions are very important, and there's always consequences, right? So I feel like this is someone that might be a bit older and is worried about future outcomes of things, the result of things, because there's decisions here that need to be made. The Two of Wands is at the bottom of the deck. This is choosing a path. Let's get one more. What do we need to know about the Seven of Pentacles and the Emperor? What do we need to know about this Seven of Pentacles and the Emperor? What do we need to know about the Seven of Pentacles? This one. Queen of Swords. Holy smokes. Aquarius, Libra, Gemini energy. This is definitely about communication. This Emperor is worried about what to say, how to communicate. A conversation is very important here. And bottom of the deck is the Ace of Pentacles. How else to share with Virgo what I picture with them, what I feel about them, what I want our future to be like? Knight of Pentacles came up, and now the Ace of Pentacles. The Ace of Cups is also here. So I feel like this is someone that's thinking about building something or making an offer of some sort, having a new beginning of some sort. Let's get some more insight into what's in their heart space. What are they thinking, feeling for you, Virgo? What do we need to know about this person? What's in their heart space when it comes to Virgo? What are they thinking, feeling about Virgo? What are they thinking, feeling about Virgo, Spirit? What are they thinking, feeling about Virgo? You will always be in my heart. All right. Strong feelings here for you, Virgo. You will always be in my heart. I feel like you have a history with this person. What else? What else do we need to know about this person's feelings towards Virgo? Taking charge. Okay, there's that Emperor energy. This person definitely wants to do something about what they're feeling. The Magician is here. The Emperor is here. And now we have this taking charge energy. The Adventure card is also about taking risks and initiative. Everything reminds me of you. Yeah, I think for a lot of you, there is something about you that's, again, I'm just going to sound like a broken record here, Virgo, but, you know, please let me know if this is resonating for you in the comments, because it's definitely a reading for one of you that's watching. This is somebody that has tried to replace you, or they just can't forget you. They just can't forget you. Everything reminds me of you. You will always be in my heart. Bottom of the deck, thinking of you. And I feel like some of you are dealing with a person who should not be thinking about you in this way. They should be happy where they're at, and they're not. Their mind drifts back to you. I know that you are my soulmate is behind that. And I'm just curious. I'm going to get one more behind this. I am removing myself from a difficult situation. This bad luck, punishment, karma, curse card here. I think this person is just not happy. Their life has taken a turn. And they're thinking about you. They haven't made any action towards you, but rest assured, they are thinking about you. And I feel like they definitely want to communicate. Let's look at their intentions for the future. Because I feel it's something with communication. Spirit, what is this person's intention for the future when it comes to Virgo? Oh, hang on. Just dropped two cards. What are their intentions towards Virgo in the near future? What are this person's intentions towards Virgo in the near future? Oh, yeah, this person. Two of Swords with the King of Swords. So again, they want to communicate, but they have to make that decision, because right now it's like they normally would just do it and like let the chips fall where they may. Who cares? I'm shooting my shot. I'm doing what I want to do. I just need to get this off my chest. But they are second guessing themselves here. They're undecided, unsure, a little guarded, even though what they want to do is open up and be honest, direct. Just the King and Queen of Swords, they're not like the King and Queen of Cups that like, I almost look at them like they just give you the PowerPoint bullet points, the King and Queen of Swords, whereas the King and Queen of Cups would tell you a story. This is somebody that just wishes they could just spill the beans, be honest, just tell you how they feel, and they are blocked. Let's see what's at the bottom of the deck, because I'm curious. Oh my gosh. The Devil. Capricorn energy there. I feel like this is someone who is in a difficult situation, in a stuck situation. They are laying down in a bed of their own making. Whoever this is not happy. They're stuck. They're feeling trapped. They might be dealing with addictions or just, you know, the consequences of their crappy decisions. You could be dealing with a Capricorn. Does not have to be. Oh, yeah. Wherever they're at, it's like war over there. Deception, difficulty, conflict. That's what's holding them back. This person, if it wasn't for this obstacle, they would have already talked to you. I think they would have already made this happen because they're manifesting this. Like this is literally, I feel also like this person might be manifesting without thinking they're manifesting because they're thinking about you that much. You might be like connected, you know, like in the 5D or something. Maybe you talk to each other in dreams or, you know, there's like a bond here that they feel, the Two of Cups. that they haven't been able to find elsewhere. They haven't been able to replace you, but not just that. Not only were they not able to replace you, Virgo, they're also miserable where they tried to replace you, or miserable because they made decisions trying to maybe forget you. You know, like, I hope that made sense. That's what I have for you. Hopefully you enjoyed this reading. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe if you haven't already. I would love to have you. If you're interested in entering the giveaway, check the description box for all of the details so that you can make sure that your entry will count. And hopefully I will see you all in another video very soon. Take care.